The Earth Day Special. Brought to you by Time Warner.
Vic!
What?
Vic, come on, hurry up.
What the hell did you do with the poker chips?
You see how it's starting?
Oh, I gotta go, Paul. I'm gonna be late.
Vic, do you know what today is?
What, Valentine's Day?
No.
Your birthday?
No, it's Earth Day.
Earth Day? What the hell is Earth Day?
Come here, sit down.
No, I gotta go, Paul.
Listen to me. I've been reading a lot about the environment, you know, and nature, and what we've been doing to this planet.
Well, that's great. You can tell me about it, but I gotta go.
No, because there's a television show on about it right now.
Wait a minute. You expect me to sit here and watch a TV show about nature?
You got it.
I'm sorry. You got the wrong guy. I'm history. I'm out of here. I'm a vapor trail.
Victoria, please.
All right, but just a couple minutes.
Oh, yes.
Well, come on, what is this?
Great.
What kind of a TV show?
Here, I'm going to crack you a nice walnut here.
Well, that sounds good. That's natural.
Mm-hmm.
Could be like a couple of squirrels here.
We have searched the skies for signals. Our spacecraft have explored dozens of exquisite worlds in the family of our sun. But as far as we've looked, there's only one place in the entire universe where the miracle of life exists. Our own planet, Earth. Life is so rare and precious. We must safeguard, protect, and cherish it.
We'll be right back. don't look like the Cucamonga Carrot Festival to me. What's up, Doc?
It's an all-star gala celebration. The 20th anniversary of Earth Day.
Celebration? What do they got to celebrate? I was at the first Earth Day. If you ask me, people ain't learned nothing. I live on the Earth. I ought to know. Pesticides, toxics. I tell you, these days, it's a shame. A rabbit like me has to wash his own carrots.
Look, look! I tried to a mellow tweet. I did see a mellow tweet. Wait for a meme.
Those polluters shouldn't have oughtn't to get away with it. This was a great place to live till man set foot on it.
Earth! What a concept! Yes! What a wonderful thing, Earth Day, friends! Yes, indeed! But hey, haven't we forgotten somebody here? Helen, come on! Who paved this? The little beavers? I don't think so. I mean, who lit this square? Was it the lightning bugs? No, Betty, no, it wasn't. Hey, who makes this planet the show place of progress that it is?
Man!
Yes, indeed. Man! Yes, you know what I'm saying. Yeah. And also Woe Man, too. That's right. Let's not forget them. You know, we've been in this together from the beginning when Adam saw Eve and went, whoa, man. Yeah. Long time ago, it was that way. And what makes us so special? What makes us the top of the food chain? Is it that little prehensile thumb? Maybe. Maybe the dinosaurs didn't have that. There was Tyrannosaurus Rex going, I can't open a beer. No. Is it that? Maybe. Maybe it's that, but I think it's something else, friends. I think it's something wonderful. You know what it is? It's because we have something big. Something incredibly big. Yeah. And man has always had it. The incredibly large brain. Yeah. That's what makes us so wonderful. That's why God said, let there be light. But it was man who said, let me charge people for it. Yeah. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed, and you know it's true. We used to be hunter-gatherers, now we're shopper-borrowers, aren't we? What happened? Why is it so wonderful? Was it maybe a long, long time ago? Maybe there was our ancestors sitting in a cave in the dark, picked up a rock and went, boo! That's not the way. But there's something here. Picked up another rock, banged the two of them together, went, ah! And a tiny spark fell from there, landed on the ground, and little piece of tinder there, little piece of dried, something caught on fire. Bang, it was there, a little flame rose up. And our primitive ancestor reached down, touched that and went, oh, fire! That was the beginning. That fire, boy. And he put some more stuff on there and that smoke went up in his face. And he went, I'm hungry, I don't know why. And he thought to himself, you know what would go real good with this? A chicken. Yeah, and that began that quest for power, friends. And there were people around, even back then, going, we gotta be careful, people. Fire, you know, you gotta watch out. Fire can get out of control, and it's got waste products. And they said, hey, it's just an ember. You throw it in a stream, and it washes downstream, and somebody else is there going, hey, what's this? Hey, this is my toilet. What are you doing? I said, hey, brother, come on. Relax, spread out. We've got a whole planet, don't we, friends? We got a whole planet. Yes, indeed. Yes. Come on now, what was this Earth before man was here? What was this planet? It was nothing but a view. Come on. Yeah, you couldn't see the view for all those trees. You cut them down, bingo. You got to start, and you get on from there, and maybe add a little electricity. Yes, there's Thomas Edison sitting in a small room playing with his bulbs, and bingo. Bingo, a light goes on. Yeah. Yeah, you know what I'm saying. Hey, and a long time ago, maybe that was it. There was Albert Einstein fishing and went, fishing? That's a good idea. Let's stay with that. Nuclear energy. There's something wonderful. Hey, so of course it has a few waste products. You put it in the ground and nature goes, get it back. It's not that you can build from there, friends. It's incredible because we have the power, and we have even better than that. We got fusion. Do you know what that is? That's where you put two particles together, smack them together real big, and bingo. You know what happens? You got a sun. That's right. We can turn the planet into a sun. Then we'll have two suns, and you'll get an incredible tan. Yeah. Yes, sir. People come from miles around. But tell me, what do you read by a beaver? I don't think so. What powers that CD? A little hamster on a treadmill? I don't think so. It's man and power, and that's what it's about, isn't it? Because we need it. We're there. It's progress. It's all part of it. And people say, we're ruining the planet. I say, honey, we ruined this one. We'll find another one. What are you worried about? Everyone's saying Mother Nature, Mother Earth. People say, we got to respect Mother Earth. Well, we do. But she loves us. She's always there for us, isn't she? She's always got one more tree up her sleeve, doesn't she? And she's the type of mom who could never say no.
Little Homo sapiens. You don't know me. I'm not surprised. Hard to recognize me anymore. Oh, once I was so fresh, so green. My skies were so blue. I was pristine. I'm Mother Earth. And I'm sick. And it's all your fault.
Me? Why is it always my fault?
You spoiled so many of the beautiful things I gave you. You swarmed all over me, shoving all the other species out of your way. How come you think you're the only one who deserves to live here? You know, for a long time, I was all right. But then came the Industrial Revolution and that damned assembly line and mass production, and everything changed. The pace of life picked up. Then there were the factories and the smokestacks and the cars and the fumes and the pesticides and the chemicals and the disposable this and the disposable that.
Oh, come on, Mom. Suffering from a little progress envy? Come on. I mean, it's all for the better. Wonderful things. Cars. Electric toothbrushes. Mom, a hand can get real tired. Hey, bottled water. Who could ever think you'd be selling water? And the microwave. How about this, Mom? Takes you a year to grow a tomato. Takes us 1 second. We got soup.
Speed. Kill. Consume. Is that what you call living? You don't cherish the life that surrounds you. The web of life requires balance and harmony. And that's something you forgot.
Mama, is it the hole in the ozone? Wear a hat. Come on.
You don't understand, honey. I will survive. I'm just a rock floating around in space. It's you I'm worried about.
Mama, come on. Come on.
I can't.
Chill out, Mama. Make a grace.
I can't take anymore.
Mama. 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 Mama.
Moments ago, Mother Earth was rushed to this hospital where a team of specialists have gathered to determine the extent of her illness.
Her lungs are congested.
Oxygen.
Details are sketchy, but there are unconfirmed, I repeat, unconfirmed reports that Mother Earth is dying.
Stomach distended.
What is becoming increasingly disturbing here tonight is that no one seems to know exactly the extent of Mother Earth's ailments.
Dehydrated.
We have not had a statement yet from doctors who are examining Mother Earth inside the hospital, but environmental expert Dr. Carl Sagan has arrived at the scene, and I think we're going to go to him now.
In the air, there is a kind of invisible blanket of gases that keeps the heat in, makes the temperature of the Earth higher than it would otherwise be. That's called the greenhouse effect. And one of the most important gases that make the greenhouse effect go is carbon dioxide, CO2. It comes from burning fossil fuels, you know, coal, oil, gas. Every time you drive your car or turn on the furnace in your house or anything like that, there's a dispute among scientists on this issue, especially on how quickly it happens. Most think there will be significant warming by sometime in the next century. Suppose we thought it was only a, say, 10% chance it would happen. What would a reasonable person do faced with a 10% chance of such a serious consequence? Well, the military always says plan for the worst case. Insurance policies say plan for the worst case. Clearly, here too. Part of the atmosphere, tiny part of it, is the protective ozone layer. It absorbs dangerous ultraviolet light from the sun. Well, that ozone layer is in trouble. There's a big hole over Antarctica in the ozone layer. It's thinning elsewhere. And we understand the reason for this. It's a molecule called CFCs. It's in air conditioners and refrigerators. Nobody figured it was a danger. But those molecules attack ozone.
Vital signs slipping.
What is happening at the hospital, but information is very hard to come by. This is Murphy Brown reporting.
I give you 2-1, she bites it.
You know, Vic, you're so uninformed. If she bites it, we all bite it.
Let me have a clicker over here.
Why?
Just want to turn up the volume.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. All right, players, it's time now in which we have those two daily doubles to assist you. We'll put the dollar figures into the screens, and we will show you our categories, which are acid rain, garbage overload, deforestation, global warming, toxics, and finally, ozone depletion.
I can't get away from this stuff.
And Aaron, you get to make the
first selection in this round.
I'll take ozone depletion for 200, Alex.
The answer is, each 1% drop in ozone concentration is said to cause a 4% increase.
What is skin cancer?
Camilla.
What is skin cancer?
You're right, you get to pick.
I'll take garbage overload for $800.
The answer, of 200, 500, or 1,300 pounds, the estimated amount of garbage each American dumps per year.
200.
Guess again.
Aaron.
What is 500?
Sorry, that is wrong.
1,300.
Sandy or Camilla? Sandy.
What is 1,300 pounds?
1,300 is right, and what that means to woman and child each day.
Hey, you want to try another category?
You know, no one likes a sore winner, Paula.
Yeah, well, no one likes a polluter either.
This is downtown Julie Brown. As the hours pass, there's a change of mood here in the town square, a volatile feeling. People are frightened, confused, desperate for answers. Joining us now is Dr. Elon Spengler, brother of renowned Ghostbuster Dr. Egon Spengler, and president of Wastebusters. Tell us why you're here tonight.
Yes, I can, Julie.
Will you?
Yes. The current condition of Mother Earth is the greatest crisis in the history of this planet, and industrial toxic waste is one of the most serious threats. Our job at Wastebusters is to identify industrial polluters, track them down, and humiliate them. I've got one. You there. Nathan Thurm. Mr. Thurm? Nathan Thurm, why are you trying to avoid us?
I'm not trying to avoid you. Why would I be trying to avoid you? That's so funny that you think that.
You are Nathan Thurm.
I know that. You don't think I know that? It's my name. I would know that.
And you are legal counsel and spokesperson for Diversified Industries?
No, I'm not.
Your name is on the letterhead.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is. I have it right here. Would you like to read it?
You read it.
I have read it.
Then why should I have to read it?
Because it's your letterhead.
I know that. You don't think I know that? It's my letterhead. I'm quite aware of that. Is it me or is it him? It's him, isn't it?
Mr. Thurm, are you aware that the industrialized nations manufacture some 65,000 different chemicals, some of which have never been thoroughly tested for their effects on the environment?
No, they don't.
Yes, they do. It's a proven fact.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
You think it is?
I know it is.
I know that.
And are you aware that this year in the United States, 275 million tons of hazardous waste will be generated? That's a million tons of toxics for every man, woman, and child in the country.
So what are you saying? That seems rather generous, a million tons per child. Oh, you think that's a bad thing?
Yes, I think it's a bad thing.
Is that what you say or is that what they say?
That's what everyone says.
I know it's a bad thing. Why are you acting like I'm to blame? Not all companies are polluters. Why am I suddenly the bad guy?
You seem a little defensive, Mr. Thurm.
I'm not defensive. You're the one who should be defensive. You're the one who thinks that hairdo works with that overly long face of yours.
What does my haircut have to do with anything?
I don't know. You're the one who brought it up.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did. Can you believe this guy? Why are you always pointing the finger at other people? Why don't you point the finger at yourself? Do a little less reading, a little more primping in the mirror. What, you don't think you need that? That's so funny that you think that, and yet sad, don't you think?
Mr. Thurm, industrial irresponsibility is directly at fault for thousands of pollution incidents every year.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
I know that.
Then what do you suggest we do about it?
How should I know? Maybe the government should have stricter regulations.
So you'd be in fish?
I didn't say that. Government intervention? Where do you think we are, on the soil of Albania? People buy our products. It makes them happy. What's wrong with that? Is something wrong with that? I don't understand. If people are so concerned about the environment, then they have the choice. They can either buy the product or not.
Oh, so you think it's up to the consumer to influence these companies?
I didn't say that.
Yes, you did.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
You think I did?
I know you did.
I know that. Yet do you think being this literal is interesting? It's not interesting at all. It's rather boring. Look at your crew. They're dozing off. Look at them.
Whoa, 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 whoa! You kids can't come in here.
But we brought these from Mother Earth.
Oh, do you expect to slow down global warming with these three crummy little trees?
They're saplings.
You kids are saps. Look, you look like smart kids, okay? What causes a hole in the ozone?
Leaky car air conditioners? Right. Fossil burning fuels?
Correctamundo. Less ozone, hotter earth. Hotter earth, more air conditioning needed. More air conditioning, less ozone. Bingo, hotter earth. It's an endless cycle, kids. Forget it.
No, you've got global warming and ozone depletion all mixed up.
Just quit whining and give me the trees, okay? Global warming, ozone depletion. Kids ever heard of marbles? That's all I had.
Great Scott!
What?
Not good. What's not good?
The future. It's not good.
Vic. This attitude just makes me crazy.
All right, Paul. What do you want me to... All right, I understand. I'm watching a TV show. The environment is screwed up and there's nothing we can do about it, okay?
You're right, Vic. There's absolutely nothing anybody can do about it. Fine. Fine.
In an astonishing turn of events, Dr. Emmett Brown has exploded into the town square in a tremendous flash of light. Miraculously, no one was hurt. All we know is that he rushed into the hospital. Stay tuned for further details. This is Murphy Brown reporting.
Not good. Not good.
Where is she?
What do you think you're doing? No one's allowed up here.
Am I too late?
For what?
For what? To soothe her, comfort her, whatever it takes.
Nurse, give me security right away.
Still beautiful despite what we've done to her.
You should go. We have her resting comfortably.
We're doing everything we can.
Everything?
Yeah. Everything's under control.
Control, a word often misused, for if we really had control, we wouldn't be in this potentially disastrous situation.
Give me security right away.
Wait! There's much to learn. I'm here to help you. Give me your tie, quick. Yes, yes, yes! Gentlemen, madam, behold the world of your children.
You want me to believe this is the future?
No, this is the present. I've been to the future. It's not that good. Gentlemen, madam, in the year 2057, the last of the glorious rainforests will be gone. I've been there.
What are we gonna do?
You know what you are, buddy? An alarmist in a crackpot.
You think? Do you think? Don't answer that. Think about it. You think I'm a crackpot? What if I'm not? What if I'm right? And you were a man who couldn't understand the danger he was in.
Is there a solution?
I'm looking for one. How much time have I got?
None.
That's plenty. I'll be right back. Here's your tie.
I am learning so much from watching this show.
Gee, I had no idea the Earth was already in such bad shape. Come on, doesn't this show get you thinking?
Yeah, about dinner. What do you say we get something to go from Burgers by Leroy?
Oh, I don't think that's a good idea.
I'll say, after one of their guacamole burgers, I'm not safe around an open flame.
Oh, Ma, that's not it. Well, that's part of it. But the point is, somebody should tell Burgers by Leroy that the polystyrene foam that they pack their food in is completely non-biodegradable, and the chemicals used in the process can be toxic.
Not half as toxic as that magic sauce.
Well, it'd be nice if they'd stop making polystyrene foam altogether. But until they come up with something better or safer, people shouldn't throw it away. It can be reused, too.
Rose, not enough. You making that up?
Burger places should have recycle bins. Because polystyrene foam can be used for lots of things. Park benches, cases for videotapes.
And I've always had my suspicions about rice cakes.
Well, unless we do something about it, no one's going to be able to say for certain what's going to happen in the future.
To do something, I really do, but I'm just one person.
Not according to the bathroom scale.
Oh, Blanche, everybody's just one person. That's why everybody has to help out. And you know, we can start by carpooling to prevent smog, using our air conditioners less, and recycling as much as we can.
Actually, I guess I've been recycling for years. I've used Mel Bushman many times. Many, 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 many times.
Well, after watching this, I'm determined to start...
Sure. We're determined now, but what about in 2 days? Or in 2 weeks? Will we still be determined to save our planet then?
Besides ozone thinning and greenhouse warming, there's a bunch of other serious environmental problems, maybe not worldwide in extent yet, but serious. Acid rain is an example. And they can be dealt with. Acid rain can be dealt with by making sure that the industrial pollutants from don't make it to the outside air. Every one of us can and should play a role in dealing with these problems, but it's very clear that industries and governments have to play a really major role.
Molecules don't have...
And now, Weekend Update with anchorperson Dennis Miller.
Weekend Update has learned that this set, the desk, the wall, and the map are non-biodegradable plastic. The only thing here that's biodegradable, in fact, is me, even the threads of polyester. So I hereby pledge that along with the other 28,000 TV news anchor persons in America, next Earth Day, we'll all do the news without a set and completely naked. No plastic whatsoever, except, of course, for Sam Donaldson's hair and Deborah Norville's expression. The EPA reports this week that the United States produces over 300 million tons of toxic waste each year. That's more than one ton of waste per every man, woman, and child. You know, I better get busy here. It is already April, and I've only produced about 6 pounds of it myself. Billions of disposable diapers are thrown away every year in the United States, and as an Earth Day observance, every baby in the United States this year will just hold it until tomorrow.
I sure hope Doc gets back here soon.
Dr. Hauser, if that man comes back into this room, I'm holding you personally responsible.
Good! Very good!
What's good?
The solution. I would have been back here sooner, but I got distracted by an incredible journey. It began with a drink from the mighty Mississippi River. It was the year 1631. The water was so clean, so pure. And suddenly it was 1900, and I found myself in a little town nestled in a broad basin, surrounded by beautiful snow-capped mountains and breathtaking blue sky. It was something that none of us will ever have a chance to see again.
What were you looking at?
Los Angeles. My journey carried me through time. To Asia, Africa, Europe. Seeing how the world used to be and how it has become, but always looking for the solution. Where was I going to find it? I needed to think, so I stepped into a little cafe in Kathmandu to read a newspaper from home. And suddenly, it hit me. I knew where to find the solution. It was in the most exhilarating, exciting, enlightening place I've ever been in my life. It's a place all of you must visit.
Where?
The library. Right down the street. With the help of Mrs. Porter, the librarian, I offer you the solution.
Look, Doc, these are newspaper and magazine clippings from the environmental crisis and scientific papers.
You see this stuff on TV all the time.
We do know all this stuff.
There's hope for you yet. There's hope for all of us because we know what to do. It's all here. It's not a secret. It's not a mystery. Isn't it amazing that we humans know what to do to save ourselves and yet we don't act on it? What's wrong with us? Have we gone mad?
So what can we do?
Get informed. Get active. Help her get well. I gotta go. I left my dog Einstein back in 1951. Farewell, my friends. You too. I know we can do it.
You know, it sure gets pretty good reception here in the swamp. Huh, Robin?
Yeah, especially now that they've got cable.
We've got it to watch the Gator Bowl.
Hey, Uncle Kermit, this Earth Day show makes it look like things are pretty bad for the people.
Yeah. Well, actually, it's worse for the animals.
You mean like us? Well, what's all this stuff doing to us?
It's killing us off.
Yeah. You see, when people mismanage the Earth, they destroy our homes.
Yeah, and the next thing you know, another species is extinct.
Oh, I'd hate to be extinct, even for a few minutes.
Well, you don't become extinct for a few minutes, Robin. It's forever.
This swamp used to teem with life, but it's quieter now. Some of the old animals are gone.
Well, all this doesn't seem to have much effect on people. There's more of them all the time.
True.
Hey, Uncle Kermit. Could we become extinct?
Well, it's possible, unless people can try to fix the damage they've caused to the Earth.
So it's really not up to us.
No, it's not. It's up to people.
Up to them, 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 up to them.
Excuse me, can I sit here?
No, go ahead, it's free country.
Yeah. Hi, I'm every man.
Hi.
And you?
Every lawyer.
Really?
Yeah.
Who do you represent?
People.
What people?
What do you think of what's going on around here?
Well, I'm a little concerned.
About what?
Well, to begin with, the oceans are polluted.
What, the oil slicks?
Yeah, that's it.
What's your name again?
Every man.
Every man. Did you ever see an oil slick?
Oh, well, just on TV.
Yeah, but not personally.
No.
Every man.
Yeah.
You know a lot of people.
Well, yes, I do.
You ever spoken to anybody that's seen an oil slick?
No.
Must be a lot of ocean that doesn't have oil slicks.
Yeah, right? I guess, yeah.
So what's the problem?
I don't know. Well, it's polluted, you know?
Worst case scenario.
All right.
Let's say the oil slicks over every ocean in the world.
Mm-hmm.
Means you can't swim in them.
Yeah.
You can't fish in them.
Well.
You can always do something. You can take a little sailboat.
Well, my jet ski.
Putt-putt. There you go.
Well, what if the water gets on you, though?
Let's say you're on a freeway going 60 miles an hour.
Yeah.
Do you put your hand out the window and try to touch the ground?
No way.
So when you're in a boat and the ocean gets on you, you keep your hands inside the boat.
Yeah, you better.
You don't touch the water. It doesn't touch you.
What about the fish, though?
Let's take your worst case scenario.
Okay.
Let's say all the fish in the world are poisoned.
Really?
Dead. You can't eat them anymore.
Yeah.
Nobody will be able to eat fish.
Right.
You ever taste imitation crab meat?
Once, yeah.
Isn't it delicious?
It was.
Tell me the truth. Could you tell the difference?
No, I was a little stringy, but...
Yeah, it's better than having a dead crab.
Dead crab?
You ever try to break open a dead crab?
No.
All right. Now they have imitation crab meat. Soon they'll have imitation tuna, imitation swordfish, imitation wahoo.
The imitation wahoo?
Not yet.
Really?
But if they pollute all the oceans, they'll start working on that. What other problems you got?
Well, they're cutting down the rainforest.
You ever see the rainforest before they were cut down?
No.
They were so big you'd get lost in them.
Really?
And if they're that big, they're too big.
I bet so.
You don't need them, right? What are you going to do, take a vacation there?
No.
Did you ever want a vacation in the rainforest?
No, I didn't.
What's your name again?
Every man.
Every man. Mm-hmm. You know a lot of people.
Mm-hmm.
You tell me one person you know that ever wanted to go for a vacation in the rainforest.
I don't know one.
Let's say you wanted to take your family for vacation.
Well,
and you went to the rainforest.
Yeah.
You get there, you turn around, you can't find your kid.
No.
You're going to pray for a little open space.
You bet I would.
Some cut down trees, a little cleared area.
Yeah, I bet I would.
Paved highway, nursing station.
I'd be looking for it.
That's right. What other problems you got?
Well, if you cut.
What else is bothering
you? Well, polar ice caps are melting. That's something.
So what?
What do you mean?
So they're melting. So you won't see them anymore.
Yeah.
They're in National Geographic.
Really?
Where are they?
Well, they're in Antarctica.
What's where?
Antarctica.
What's special about Antarctica besides polar ice caps?
Well, it's got snow. It's got polar bears.
You want snow, you go to Maine. You go to Canada. You go to Vermont. You have a little bed and breakfast place there. You get a little chalet.
Yeah, but
you don't need to go to Antarctica. Well, for the snow.
But there's a hole in the ozone.
There's a hole in the ozone.
Right. If that ozone, you have a hole in it, then those ultraviolet light gets through, and then you have your skin cancer.
You never heard of sunscreen?
No.
You can't put on a little 15 or 22. What are you, a baby?
No.
If it's really bad, you put on 32, 42.
42.
If it's that bad during the day, zinc oxide blocks it right out.
You put that zinc oxide on, you look like a mime.
You're worried about hole in the ozone?
Well, I was, yeah, but.
You ever go into a burning building?
No.
Doesn't make sense, does it?
Not at all.
You don't walk off a cliff, do
no.
you? No. Doesn't make sense.
Doesn't make sense.
You don't walk out the 10th floor of an open window, do you?
Not
that
recently.
That doesn't make sense. Does it make sense to go to where a hole is if it's in Antarctica?
It's pretty stupid, you're
Are
right.
you going to go to Antarctica?
No, sir.
Because there's a hole there.
Right in the ozone.
What's your name?
Every man.
You're lucky you met me. The way you think you could have been dead within a year.
Bet I would.
What other problems you got? What's bothering you?
Well, the atmosphere is polluted.
The atmosphere is very bad. It is a big problem.
Well, you can't breathe. Sometimes it burns.
You bet your life. It hurts your lungs.
Boy, it
it's
does.
It's yellow out there.
Oh, boy, on that's
on
brown.
Those days, you stay inside.
Yeah?
You close your windows.
Okay.
Or you walk across the street to the mall.
Mall?
What's the matter with a mall?
Oh, nothing.
You don't like malls.
I love them.
You better.
I do.
You could spend a whole day there on a floor. You wouldn't see the whole thing.
Really?
On one level. They got everything there, right?
Everything. That's sure. Right. I'm thinking about that.
They got cashew shops.
Oh.
They got sneaker stores.
Nothing but sneakers. The sneakers
right.
and things.
Aren't they wonderful?
That's wonderful.
And
I go on.
Food?
Food is incredible.
You can have any kind of food
oh,
you
anything
want.
You want.
You can have Chinese
Lithuanian?
Food. Right. Mexican
well, maybe not now.
Food.
Yeah. That's wonderful.
You can have Mexican food, Chinese
Mexican
food.
Yogurt, I bet.
Where?
I don't know.
Where they have Mexican yogurt?
I don't know they had that yet.
What mall is
that? I'm not sure there is that yet, but wouldn't that be wonderful?
No acid rain in a mall.
That's true.
No smog in a mall.
Oh, that's right, boy.
Don't you worry about atmosphere.
Yeah.
You get all the atmosphere you want in a mall.
You're right, though.
And
it's pretty,
safe.
It's comfortable.
It's comfortable.
Yeah, but wait a minute. While we're comfortable in there, you still got that acid rain falling outside. It's going to kill all the plants, and then there goes photosynthesis. How are we going to breathe?
Photosynthesis.
Yes.
Photosynthesis.
Say it again.
That old saw.
That's it. Well, that old saw, what do you mean?
What is photosynthesis?
Well, that's where we breathe out carbon dioxide, then they give us back
don't
oxygen.
Don't tell me what. I know what photosynthesis is. I'm not asking you what photosynthesis is. I'm telling you that the jury is out on photosynthesis.
What are you talking
photosynthesis
about?
Photosynthesis can be argued both ways.
Well, wait, we need plants and flowers.
Yeah, well, let me tell you something. Plants and flowers in the wrong hands is a dangerous thing.
Really?
Oh, yeah. You go into a hospital.
Yeah.
You go into a patient's room and it's filled with flowers and
yeah.
plants.
Mm-hmm. They're all there.
Right. What's the first thing a nurse does when she goes in that room?
Well, at nighttime, she takes them out.
Why?
Well, because they consume the air.
Bingo.
Ouch. Oh, boy.
Don't be nervous. Relax.
I'm a little concerned.
What's Mr.
Everyman?
Everyman. You're living in the best country in the world. Where are you living?
America.
That's right, because you elect the people you want to represent you.
Mm-hmm.
What are they called?
Politicians.
What did they just pass? The new Clean Air and...
Water Act.
Right. They spent months working on it.
Oh,
that
they
bill,
did, boy.
They? Mm-hmm. Was this long?
Longer.
And then they beat it up a little bit,
little
didn't
bit,
they?
Yeah.
Punched holes in it.
Yeah, compromised.
Yeah. Compromised it right down to here
mm-hmm.
for good reason. Why?
Well, the lobbyists.
The lobbyists work for...
Special interest groups.
Special interest groups serve...
The corporations.
And who are the corporations?
Well, executives and then lawyers.
People.
Like you.
What are you worried about?
I don't know. I mean, after what I've heard today and all I've seen it, I don't buy it.
Don't buy what?
What you said, the logic of
about
it. Well, the atmosphere, the ozone, rainforest,
hey,
polar ice caps.
I can always argue the other side.
Doc's right. This makes perfect sense. We have got to act on what we already know.
Dr. Hauser, there's some things that you don't understand. We don't know the extent of her injuries. We don't even know if the proposed solutions are solutions at all. And solutions cost money and can raise the price of products. Are you willing to pay more, Dr. Hauser? Our economy could suffer. You willing to take that responsibility?
Sure, we've got to consider all those things, but our environment is in jeopardy. Somebody has to do something.
I think you worry a little bit too much, Dr. Hauser. Mother Earth's a lot tougher than you think. Before we take action that we might regret, I think we should study the problem just a little bit further. Who knows, she may even be able to get better by herself.
Sorry.
Do you think the world's really coming to an end?
Yeah.
My dad says it's all a bunch of bull.
I don't know. We were watching the news the other night, and they were talking about how the Great Lakes are all polluted. And my mom and I got real scared because things are so messed up and we didn't know what to do about it.
Thank you.
planet so all the people could understand that all of the world should bear witness that toxic waste is serious business. We can make the world much better, but we have to do it all together. So make it plain so they won't forget it. A 1, 2, 3, hit it!
Working together, get up, working together. We got to get up.
I've been recognized by the world for being humorous, but in all my years of rapping, this is the gloomiest rhyme I've ever written or bore the burden to narrate. The game is destroyed the world, now let me commentate. Every time you put a paint can in a trash can, you take a piece of the world from the next man. All together, I need your help in the worst way. Let's all take a part for the cause here on Earth Day.
Toxic chemicals are so corrosive, everything flammable and even explosive. Things you do to get your apartment clean, turpentine furniture, polish and benzene. Ammonia paint, disinfectant and batteries, collars that kill all ticks and fleas. They even spray to kill ants and roaches. Got a way to be disposed, got proper doses.
Anything for a dollar, this attitude destroys. The next generation can't enjoy. They continue to build. We take our water for granted. How many oil spills will it take to awake or catch a bad break? If not for our sake, for our children's sake, we need a solution to put pollution to an end. This is a prayer from a friend.
Toxins boxing, blowing out the atmosphere. Greenhouse effect. You wanna live here? Well, you got no choice, cause Earth's our home. Stop polluting, fool, inspect your dome. The true fact is we're living on overkill. You bought a new house, it's on a landfill. Your eyes sting the fifth, your next breath could cause your death. Check.
Working together, we got to.
I'm not a scientist or a scholar. I'm here to holler about those who came for the almighty dollar. Kid and play, in effect. Not on the comedy tip, I'm just fed up, so I'ma let it rip. It doesn't take the smart or the strong or the song
to realize that wrong is wrong.
All the abuses and the excuses
just can't it.
Why? It's time to save the planet.
Take a look upon the ocean. What once was the magic is now the poison potion. A place used for toxic dump waste. Drink a glass of water, get a bad taste, then look. All of my fish are dying, and old Father Sea is crying. If we don't change, here's how it'll be. Dead fish, dead sea, dead meat.
Mother Earth's condition remains unchanged. Early on in the evening, there was a feeling of panic in the crowd. Mother Earth, ailing, sick, perhaps even dying. Then moments ago, fear gave way to hope as children took to the stage with a glowing book. They were joined by parents and friends. People are taking turns reading from the book, a practical guide filled with things we can do right now to save Mother Earth.
Acid rain, air pollution, and global warming are problems we can do something about.
We're here to save Mother Earth, and the book says the best way to start is by reducing energy. Coach?
Yeah, thank you. Hey, Coach Stewart, Kennedy High. I'll tell you the truth, I'm just not the kind of guy who ever thought much about the environment, you know, till this happens. But I'm no expert, but looking through the book here, I realized, hey, kid, you got to get your act together. See, the book says that the best and the easiest way that we can use less energy is to make sure that those appliances we use every day, you know, what, your furnace, your air conditioner, your refrigerator, you make sure that those things are set properly to run efficiently, right? That's what I'm going to do at my house, huh? I'm also going to check the water heater down at the gym, make sure that's not set too high. Oh, yeah.
Transportation is one of the largest sources of air pollution.
Now, I like what I'm seeing. There's a lot that people in this world can do to help save our planet.
Well, not just in this world, Mom. There are things in this very house that we can do to conserve energy.
Right, and conserve money on our energy bills.
Dad, money's not the issue.
Well, not for you. You don't pay the bills.
Well, I have an example. We can all take short showers instead of baths. That uses half as much water.
Listen, there are things we can do in our very kitchen that will help conserve energy. Vanessa and Miss Rudy, if you would not standing open for 10 minutes at a time while you decide what it is you're going to eat.
See, what I do is I make up my mind what I want before I go to the refrigerator. That way, I open the door, get what I want, and I close it. It saves money.
Excuse me, can I have some ice cream?
No. You know why? Because you use up too many cows.
No, I won't.
Yes, you will. We have to save the cows.
If you want to save money, Dad, you shouldn't use so much energy when you cook. You're always taking the lids off the pots.
I've got to see what I'm cooking, idiot.
No, Dad, you're just using it as an excuse to lick on the spoon.
It's true, Cliff. Every time you open that lid, you let some of that heat out, which means it's going to take longer to cook the food, which means you're going to use more energy.
There you go.
And more money.
Okay, I'll tell you what's wasting a lot of energy. The hot air you all are blowing in my face.
But it's free, Dad.
I think we should go back to watching this program.
That is true, because we shouldn't have the TV on unless we're watching something, because it's a waste.
Of your money.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
90% of our energy comes from fossil fuels and nuclear power, huh? Now, that means that 90% of the time, when anybody is using energy for anything, they're creating toxic emissions or hazardous waste or pollution of some kind. Now, that means that the single most important thing we can do to help the environment is to use less energy, huh? Now, come on, folks, we can do it! Yeah. Hey, let Mother Earth hear it! Come on!
Percent of the used oil that's generated in Alabama comes from do-it-yourselfer oil changers. Our program may help us to recycle. They can take their used oil to one of over 200 collection centers in our state. The collector pumps out the oil at the collection center and takes it to a reprocessing facility like this one, where the used oil is filtered and cleaned and processed as a fuel oil, which is used by industries. Over 90% of what is brought into a reprocessing facility can be recycled. And this is the type of program that could be duplicated anywhere in our nation. Most people don't realize how used oil can impact on their lives. We all generate it in the vehicles we drive every day. For example, the oil from one oil change can pollute 1 million gallons of water. That's enough fresh water for 50 people for an entire year. Each one of us are a part of the problem, and yet there's a way that we can address it and have a part in solving it.
If all the water in the world could fit into a 1 gallon jug and you poured out all that was non-drinkable, too salty, polluted, or hard to get, you'd end up with one drop. And that's what we all must drink from. We can't be wasting our water. If you've got a leaky faucet, fix it. Don't leave your water running when you're shaving or brushing your teeth. Don't overwater your lawn. We've got to stop using our kitchen drains like toxic waste dumps. If you're painting, don't pour your paint down the drain. Recycle it. Where do you think it all ends up? A lot of it ends up right back in our water supply. Where do you think the pesticides go that we use to grow our produce every year? A lot of that washes right back into our own groundwater. We need clean water to live. We do. I'm going to recycle this.
Does anyone else have anything they'd like to say? Walter.
My name is Walter Sampson. I edit the local newspaper here. And what worries me, people, is the number of trees being cut down. See, I don't think people understand the value of trees. Trees absorb the pollutants put out by our factories and cars. Now, people ask me, why should we care about what happens to a rainforest like Brazil? Well, I'll tell you. Forests are the lungs of the planet. Now, if the planet stops breathing, we stop. Now, I learned tonight that every year, a forest the size of the state of Tennessee gets cut down. A forest the size of the state of Tennessee every year. Now, what can we do about that? Well, let's recycle our paper. Let's buy products made from recycled paper. Let's plant trees. Huh? Huh?
Welcome back to the dating game. And well, Kim, you've heard our bachelors. Are you prepared with your final question?
Yes, Jim.
Okay, ask away.
Okay. Bachelor number one, could you describe your ideal date?
Yeah, get right to it, Kim. I think it would be a long, explosive limousine ride up the coast, maybe to Carmel. Stop at Clint's place, have a romantic candlelight dinner. And then after that, just continue on up to San Francisco, Union Street, wonderful little dessert restaurant. And then the rest is up to you.
Mm-hmm. Sounds interesting. Okay, bachelor number two, same question.
Well, Kim, I'd say I'd jet you up to my private villa and my private helicopter on Lake Tahoe and open up a nice expensive bottle of wine. Maybe throw some freshly chopped pine on the fire and, well, get to know you in a more intimate way.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Bachelor number three.
You know, I've been asked this same question hundreds and hundreds of times. What's the question?
What is your ideal date?
Oh, well, first, I think it should be organically grown and in the right climate.
No. Bachelor number three, we're talking ideal date here. When you meet a woman, what's the first thing you look for?
A room. Sorry. My ideal day, well, Kim, I think walking is a very intimate thing. And I think first we'd take a nice, long walk together. And if the mood was right, perhaps we'd hold hands. Then we'd go bike riding on a bicycle built for one. After that, I'd take you on a beach. We'd go for a swim. Hey, that gives me a chance to show off my body, huh? Then towards evening, I'd rent a canoe. And you could just sit there for 2 hours in the moonlight and watch me paddle.
Oh, that's all there is. That's all the time we have, Kim. And now it's time to make up your mind. Will it be bachelor number one, bachelor number two, or bachelor number three?
I think bachelor number three.
Bachelor number three!
Hey, Pat, it looks like the suit didn't help you at all, huh? And you, don't you have homework to do?
All right, Kim, can you tell us why you chose bachelor number three?
Well, bachelors number one and two just didn't seem to realize the additional amounts of CO2 and nitrogen oxides that would be released on our dates. But bachelor number three, although I did find him a little revolting, he was undeniably ecologically appealing. In fact, he really pushed my buttons with all that environmental talk. I only hope he can whisper it as well as he speaks it.
Well, let's meet bachelor number three. Here he is, Dr. Vinny Boombatz.
Hey, boys, you ought to check up on the environment. Then maybe you'll get some respect. Hey, honey, the environment's getting better already, huh?
The dimensions of the toxics problem are so vast that they are almost incomprehensible. According to the EPA, hazardous waste is produced in this country at the rate of 700,000 tons a day.
What? How many?
That's 1,400,000,000 pounds every single day.
That's impossible. How could that be?
I'll tell you how that can be. My name's Charles McIntyre. I own a factory about a mile from here. A couple of years ago, my plant foreman came to me and told me I had to make a decision. We had to dispose of some hazardous byproducts from the result of our manufacturing process. He told me we could either hire a company, do it properly for $18,000, or we could just dump it out in the back lot. I chose to dump it. A class action suit was brought against my company by a neighborhood organization. It seems as though several children from that neighborhood were born with heart and lung defects, which the parents claimed were caused by mothers drinking contaminated water. Well, I hired the best lawyers money could buy. It cost my company hundreds of thousands of dollars, and you know something? We won. I'm very, very ashamed. You know, corporate America is not just some nameless, faceless entity. They're people just like me who are in positions of responsibility, who make important decisions every day. We know who we are. We know there are laws and regulations. But it's more than that. We have to stop right now making the wrong choices. I wish that I could turn back the clock. And I can't. I'm sorry.
This planet is our home. This planet is our home. We wouldn't treat the inside of our home this way. Why are we treating the planet like this? When the school district began this program, I realized, even though I'm not an advocate of polystyrene, that we needed to recycle.
This is something called polystyrene.
And the children are really running this program. The children are the ones that brought in, well, what about cans, and what about tinfoil, and what about glass? They're recycling all those products at this school, and they're doing it themselves.
Put your fork in here. Put your fork in there.
Children are a lot more with it than we give them credit for, and they have a habit of thinking a little bit more long-term than maybe some adults do. They don't really want to see the planet destroyed for themselves or their children. They have a vested interest in what's happening on the planet today. And so when you give them a tool, it empowers them to make a difference in their lives.
Down to try to add to a 7-point lead. 10 minutes left to play here, and you're struggling anytime you're playing without Magic Johnson, I'll tell you that. Here's Cooper with it. Cooper takes to Woolridge, his 18-foot jumper, that's good.
Timeout, Lakers.
Michael.
Hey, Magic, how you feeling?
I'm hurting. But not as much as Mother Earth. How's she doing?
Not good.
Sounds like she needs an assist.
So what are you gonna do with that cup when you're finished?
I'm just for Costner.
No, man. You're gonna recycle.
You know Americans only recycle 1% of their plastic items. Did you know that?
No.
Now you do.
Did you know Americans only recycle 1% of their plastic items?
Hey, I'm gonna recycle it.
Hey, Vic. You know what we should do as soon as the show is over? Glad you asked. You know, we ought to take this plastic bottle here and we should stick it in the back of our toilet. Think of how much water we would save on each flush. I knew you'd like that. You know what else? You're gonna fix that leaky faucet upstairs. And you're gonna carpool so you don't have to drive that gas guzzler to work every day. There.
Come on, pull up a high chair. Hey, Jim Chips, it's time to make a contribution to your favorite charity.
Vic, please, a moment, please.
Hey, let's get some fresh air in here. Somebody turn on the air conditioner.
Yeah, let's get some fluorocarbon.
Hey, listen, I know that Paula's got her panties all in a bunch about this Earth Day thing, but the boys and I were thinking, why don't you come up to the woods this weekend with us? We'll do a little squirrel baseball, some mink mugging, maybe a little barbecue roadkill and some bunny bashing. What do you think?
Look at his face! He bought it!
Hey, Vic, you want a beer? Here you go. Yeah, you gotta relax. You know what we do to these things when we're through with them? We recycle them.
That's the way.
What the hell is Earth Day anyway?
Oh, it's that gopher thing, isn't it?
No. What are you kidding me? You're thinking of a Groundhog Day. Gopher was a bartender on Love Boat.
No. Gopher was the steward on Love Boat. Ted was the bartender.
Yeah. All right.
What do you want these cards? You find them or shuffle them? Let's
five
go.
Five card draw. Jacks are better to open. Deuces are wild unless I deal myself something else.
Hey, Vic, here's your chips and here's your dip.
Hey, wait a minute. I only have four cards here.
Well, that's because you're a better player than we are. Vic, come over here. I want to show you something. Want to see my hand? No. Seriously, Victor, in honor of this special occasion, I would like to propose a toast to Mother Earth.
Hey, Vic, come on. This whole environmental thing is just one big yuppie craze, huh?
I quite agree. Here we are purging our guilt in the name of Mother Earth.
Yeah. Save the whales, save the trees, save your breath.
Yeah, well, what, a big rock star will have a benefit concert and the whole thing will be forgotten.
I'm thinking free.
Just like the day after tequila.
That's right. Who won the Oscar? Anybody remember that?
Oh, what about that guy Morton Downey Jr.? Where's he now?
Where is she?
People forget that stuff all the time.
Hi, Wagon, where are you going?
Hey, come on,
we're playing. Look at this.
Happy Earth Day, Vic!
Vic, this is all your fault.
What's the matter? What, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Yeah.
Not too long, guys.
I came to say hello.
Hello.
How are you feeling?
Not good.
There's a lot of people down at the square, and we got this book, and E.T. said if we just told everybody, so I'm gonna turn off all my lights and...
We want you to get better. Everybody's talking about you, and... It's gonna take a lot more than talk. You're too young, but I remember the first Earth Day, about 20 years ago. It was a Sunday, just like today, and people were talking, saying all the right things. They got excited. I got excited. And then something happened that changed everything.
What?
Monday. You see, today's Earth Day. You're full of big plans, big ideas, big hopes. And then Monday comes, and people forget.
Maybe it'll be different this time.
Why? What's gonna change?
God, what kind of people would let such a thing happen to our planet?
Gee, Daddy, is the Earth really coming to an end?
Not fast enough for me, Pumpkin.
Gee, I wish there was something we could do to help. Yeah. I mean, this Earth belongs to us all.
Right.
I say it's up to us to set an example for the whole neighborhood.
You're right, son. Let's get started right now. You with me?
Yeah.
You people are beasts. Now, this is important to the survival of the planet.
Marcy's right. Come on, guys. This time, let's really save the Earth.
Look, Fred, Wilma. peer up the evolutionary chain for just a minute and try to imagine what this house would look like had it been dusted in the last 10 years. Now, that's what the Earth could look like if we'd all pitch in. I mean, what do you do when you're done with your aluminum cans?
Well, first we do this. Then we toss them on your lawn.
Well, then it's you I have to thank. Because I've been taking these aluminum cans down to the recycling center. And with the money I was refunded, I bought myself a Sting Sings for a Tree album.
Hey, wait a minute. I mean, our garbage is worth money?
Well, yeah, so to speak. Of course, you've got to separate it first. But you can get money for just about anything. Paper, plastic, cans, and glass.
Get that garbage. Come on. Watch it now. Come on, let me in here.
What's this piece of paper? Oh, Kelly, it's your report card.
Well, then what the hell did I burn?
I'm trying to get something out of here.
A paper cup.
Watch it now. It was mine in the morning.
Now, kids, it's for the Earth.
Hey, spaghetti? Where was I when we had spaghetti?
Look, everybody, just grab something and we'll separate it on your lawn where the bulk of the garbage is.
All right, you grab that, I'll get over there.
Mrs. Rhodes, how long can the Earth survive if we don't start doing this?
Who knows? Maybe as little as 100 years.
So what's the rush? 100 years? Hell, we'll all be dead by then.
There you go.
She really
does.
100 years. I thought this was an emergency.
Yeah.
Hey, Dad, how about you and me go fishing this weekend?
Well, I don't know, son. There really hasn't been anything biting in that lake for a long time. Don't know why.
Mm-hmm. I don't know. Oh, it's really melted. Oh, thank you.
We call this material and other materials urban ore because ordinarily, it goes to a landfill, it's buried, it then has a negative value. Our collectors remove this material from the waste stream. They bring it in here, they're paid for it. We in turn sell it to an end user that turns it back into an aluminum product. So it has a positive value at that point. Inner city communities very often are the dumping ground for the country. Our objective is to make this a cleaner community that has increased employment, that is able to work in partnership with the city and the private sector in a way that's beneficial for its residents. 20 years ago, when mostly environmentalists were telling us that we had to recycle, we thought that they were a pretty odd bunch of folks. And now we've come to realize that they were pretty prophetic in pointing us toward a new way of managing this troublesome waste stream.
By the year 1991, one-third of the nation's landfills will be full. Garbage overload is a problem we have to begin to solve.
The most important thing we can all do is recycle our glass, aluminum, plastics, and polystyrene.
And try to buy recycled products.
How about a beer?
Beer? Fine, that would be great. Any kind.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. No, I'm not okay. You know, I couldn't stand it out there. I hate thinking about this stuff. What if we have screwed it up so bad that they can't fix it? I mean, I think it's crazy what we're doing, you know?
Sure is.
It's very, very, very bad.
It's bad?
It's terrifying.
Can be.
Okay, that's enough agreeing. Thank you very much. But bartenders are supposed to make you feel better.
I can do that.
I don't really think you could. I mean, out there, you know, they're talking about the rainforest. Do you know that the rainforest is being destroyed at the rate of a hundred or thousands of acres every minute or day? And there's a hole in the, it's this enormous hole up in this...
In the ozone.
Right, and it's the 3 times the size of something.
It's the size of the United States.
Okay, so, you
know. You know, I used to be scared like you.
Yeah, you did?
Are you kidding? I was so scared I pretended that none of it was happening. But that didn't make it any better, so I decided to do something about it.
So what'd you do?
See this? Low-flow aerator. Cuts down water use by 50%.
Oh, that's good.
You see this shirt? It's washed with phosphate-free detergent.
Really?
You know why that's important?
No.
Where do you think all the dirty water goes from your wash?
Probably down the drain.
Some of it winds up in our rivers and lakes. You don't want to kill fish, do you?
No, God, I don't want to kill anything.
And these? I recycle these.
That's it? That's what you do? It's good. I don't want to hurt your feelings, but it just seems a little tiny and pathetic. I mean, considering how enormous the problem, the overwhelming, the size of it. I mean, the sheer...
You need to do something.
What? Think I should get a low-flow aerator?
Yeah. Do something instead of being afraid. You do something, you're going to start to feel better about yourself. Here. Take a chance. But take your time, all right? Don't rush this. This could change your life.
Yes!
That's a good shot.
I know.
That's a really good shot. Do you know what you just did?
No.
You just saved enough energy to run my TV for 3 hours.
I did?
Yes.
How did I do that?
It's the energy it takes when you, you know, when they're the old cans and the...
You mean the energy it takes to make a new can is more than what it takes to recycle an old one? Yeah, I got it.
Look, I know some of this stuff sounds trivial, but that's where it starts. You know, you do it, the guy next door does it, the whole block, and it adds up. It makes a difference. And that's why I'm going to keep doing it, because I believe in it.
I know.
You feel better?
I feel better.
Good.
I'm not sure it has anything to do with the environmental movement, however.
Look, you better go to that rally.
Yeah, I better get out of here. Oh, I forgot to pay you.
No, forget it. It's on me.
Well, it's on all of us.
Yeah, it is.
What we keep hearing over and over again tonight is the importance of recycling, but most people don't know how. It's very simple. Watch this.
Hi, I'm Gary Peterson, and we started this program back in 1972 with $2 and a Volkswagen bus. There are four types of programs. We have all four. Curbside, where you'll need different colored bins to separate the recyclables at home and trucks to pick them up. Recycling zones for multifamily areas are located in alleyways, and recyclers can walk or drive to those locations. Drop-off centers are larger facilities, usually located in rural areas, and buyback centers are where people get paid for the recyclable materials. To locate a recycling center near you, first contact your local city's Department of Public Works. If there isn't a recycling center close to you, contact your local government, church, school, civic or service organization, and see if they have a site which you could use. Also find out the city can assist you with funding your center. You'll need to purchase equipment based on the type of facility you decide on. You also need a buyer, so check your local phone directory for scrap metal or paper stock dealers. Once a program is on its way, you can be proud of the fact that you're cleaning up your environment, and you'd be happy to know you can also make a profit. For additional information, just call your state solid waste agency.
My name is Helen, and I've come here tonight because I want to tell you about my 6-year-old daughter, Melissa. Several years ago, she contracted a very rare form of blood cancer called T-cell lymphoma. So rare, in fact, that only two other children in the United States had ever had the disease. The doctors told us that she might only live for 4 more days. Can you imagine what it's like as a parent to hear that about your child? Well, we were desperate, and the doctors decided to try a new medicine. And my daughter is alive and well today because of a flower called the rosy periwinkle that used to grow in the rainforests of Madagascar. But our rainforests are being destroyed. Do you know that 72,000 acres a day are being destroyed? And if we don't do something about it, there aren't going to be any rainforests in 100 years. And the rosy periwinkle can grow artificially in a greenhouse. But what I want to know is how many species of flowers and plants are we destroying every day that could be the source of life-saving medicines tomorrow?
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm here to report on Mother Earth's condition. I wish I had better news, but I don't.
What?
The fact is, she's not going to get any better unless we start to change. So the question is, are we really going to do all the things we've talked about doing tonight? Are we really going to get involved and get active? Are we going to recycle our trash? Are we going to reduce the amount of energy we use and not waste water? Are we going to replace our appliances with energy-effective ones? Are we going to replace the trees we destroy? Are we going to reuse plastic and polystyrene products? And finally, are we going to vote? Vote with our votes, vote with our dollars? Are we going to buy environmentally friendly products? Mother Earth doesn't think enough of us are going to do any of these things. And I'm afraid she may be right.
Oof. How about that? There it is, huh, guys? Well, we're gonna have to do something here. The Earth's in trouble, and I guess it's up to us.
It's up to us? The Earth is in trouble.
Well, now, wait a minute. All right, I know what I'm gonna do here. I'm gonna, you know, from now on, I'm just gonna buy my grooming supplies in extra large containers.
Wow.
Yes, as soon as I use up these smaller ones here. Anyway, that's what I'm doing. What about you guys?
Oh, I know what I could do. Next time I stop for a six-pack, I could take a moment to snip those pesky six-pack rings.
There you go.
Good idea.
And then I've got several beer cans at home that I've sort of been laying around for the last year or so. Yeah. I could bring those down to the redemption center and cash them in. It's like two cents a can.
Okay, what are you going to do with the money?
I don't know, buy a car maybe.
Yeah,
good idea.
Non-polluting kind of car, though.
You know,
yeah.
Understand, yeah.
Electric.
Yeah.
Swollen.
Yeah.
Anyone else? What's going on?
Well, you know, for my part, I was thinking of including a personal handwritten note to each and every person on my mail route to encourage them to recycle their junk mail and catalogs.
Good one.
Well, yeah, and the handwritten note that I've included. No, better yet, I'll just write it on the junk mail.
There you go.
Huh?
I know. Cloth baby diapers.
Oh, that's good. You know, and I have heard that cloth baby diapers are better for the baby's skin.
Oh, don't forget the baby. I'm talking about polishing my Beamer. I go through a ton of paper towels.
Whoa. Mm. I'm proud of us. We've all come up. Oh, well, okay. What I'm going to do is, when I go to the laundry, I'm going to take my own garment bag so they don't have to keep giving me those plastic ones. wait. I'm not even going to drive to the laundry. I'm going to walk to the laundry. And that way it will save on gas and I will not be polluting the environment.
You know, if none of us drove anywhere, it would really help out.
Well, wait a minute. Now, wait. Woody. That makes sense. So just by sitting around and doing nothing for the rest of our lives, we're doing our part. We're doing it.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. All right. Good job. This guy's willing to start a carpool at his school.
Yeah.
I could start a recycling effort on my block.
All right. And I'm going to start recycling my oil from now on.
And I'm gonna plant these trees, and I sure as hell won't be wasting paper anymore either.
I'm not quite sure what's happening here. It's difficult to describe. The atmosphere is charged, electric. Suddenly, people are coming alive.
I want to organize a committee with the mayor's office to institute a recycling program.
I'm gonna check out my senator's and my congressman's record on the environment.
Anybody who wants to hold public office should care about the Earth. All of us should care about the Earth.
Hear, hear!
Yeah.
Yeah. Look!
have done here tonight is wonderful. And I thank you for it, truly. It's almost enough to make me believe that you really mean it this time. Well, you mind if I drop the mask for just a minute? I'm Bette Midler. I live here on this planet. I share it with you. I belong to a movement that is a grassroots movement. It's a movement to save our planet. This movement is not a hype, and being part of this movement is not a trend. We sincerely believe that our Earth is at risk, and since our Earth is at risk, we, the people of the planet, are at risk as well. It's going to take a whole lot more, though, than just one television show and all our good intentions to save Mother Earth.
And I'm Robin Williams, and these are Wayne Newton's clothes. And I'm here tonight to say that we gave you the information. Now it's up to you to get active. You can do it. It makes a difference. Go out there. Recycle. You can do that. Vote with your hearts. Vote with your hands. Vote with your dollars. And vote with your votes. Don't just wait for the politicians. Come on. They're going to read an opinion poll one day and go, maybe now I'll do something.
So what do we know? We know that the Earth does not belong to us. We only inherit it for a very brief moment in time, and then we pass it along to our children.
We're a kinder, gentler nation. Come on, let's act like one. We know that all things in nature are connected, that all things are interdependent.
And so we know that whatever happens to the Earth will surely happen to the people of the Earth. We didn't weave this incredible web of life. We are only a part of it.
Whatever we do to this precious planet, in the end, we're doing it to ourselves.
And so we're counting on you. Yeah, we're counting on you. You have to get off your cans and recycle.
Tell him, Mama.
Recycle!
Reduce!
Replace!
Reuse! And most of all, rejoice. Because you have an incredible gift here. Don't blow it. Wise up. Yeah. Oh,
yeah. My son.
Oh, Mama.
You okay?
Oh, yeah, I'm okay.
What are you thinking about?
Really want to know?
Yeah, that's why I asked.
Don't laugh.
I won't laugh.
I was thinking about our grandchildren.
What grandchildren? We don't have any.
I know we don't have any, but we will someday. And what if the worst case of this happened? Or even half the worst case? And they ask us, did we see this coming? Did we know that this could happen? What are we going to tell them? What are we going to lie to them? Tell them we were too busy?
No, we can't do that.
What are we going to tell them, that we didn't care enough?
I don't know.
What are we going to tell our grandchildren?
nothing you young people can do in your life that will grow larger than these trees. Our air and our water, our wildlife, and our own existence, our own economy is dependent on trees. If these trees ever have to be cut sometime, it's okay if they're cut, but make them plant a tree back immediately after they need one for use. Okay? Somebody plant that. When you press the dirt, it gets the air pockets out, and the tree has a better chance of finding its way. Okay, remember where this is, and come back and visit with it and talk to it.
Everybody got one?
You are all going to be great tree planters. There's nothing more important than doing something for someone else, and you can do it through planting a forest for tomorrow.
Take shorter showers. Remember, shower with a friend.
These have to be serious, don't they? Okay.
Repair leaky faucets.
Carpool.
Use reusable containers for leftovers instead of foil or plastic wrap.
Buy a fuel-efficient car. I have one.
Be aware of the chemicals that are in the products you buy.
Set your lawnmower blade higher in the summer. Taller grass retains moisture.
Shower with a friend.
Turn on the hose only for quick wet downs and rinses. Water your lawn only early in the morning, huh? Or in late afternoon at prevents evaporation.
Start a program in your office or community to recycle paper, newspaper, aluminum cans, and plastic.
Recycle. Remember, walk to the corner store. Don't drive.
Plant a tree.
Use phosphate-free detergent.
Dispose of hazardous chemicals correctly.
To conserve water,
shower with a friend.
Oh, my gosh. To conserve water and energy, wait until you have a full load before running your...
You can influence decisions about pollution control permits, recycling laws, waste disposal, and other important community issues.
To conserve water and energy, wait until you have a full load before running your dishwasher or washing machine.
To recycle.
It means the world to us.
You've heard a lot of information here tonight, and there's still more to know. There are several books out now, like this one, Save Our Planet, 750 simple things that we can all do right now. We urge you to read more and learn more. Go to your local library, bookstore, and pick up one of these books. Or for more information, you can write the Environmental Protection Agency in Washington, D.C., and stay tuned to your local news tonight to find out what you can do in your own area. Remember, it's up to all of us to save our environment. We can make a difference.